Bonjour my friends, I'm Frankie and welcome to Club Foodie. When the temperature starts dropping, casseroles and foods simmering for hours becomes a weekly affair. Like cassoulet, lasagna, tuna casserole, chicken divan, tetrazzini, goulash, and so on. Here's a pasta dish that is absolutely divine that I enjoy making during this time of year. In today's episode, I'll show you how to make my pastizio. This Greek baked pasta is incredibly delicious. Made with ground beef and ground lamb, along with a nice bechamel sauce, this is the perfect flavorful casserole dish to serve to your family. So my friends, let's get cooking. In a large saucepan over medium heat, we'll add oil. And when it gets hot, we'll add the onions and sprinkle on some ground sea salt. We'll saute for a couple minutes. Now, we'll add ground lamb and ground beef. We'll cook until brown, breaking into small pieces. If you come across this kitchen tool, buy it. The meat chopper does the job so fast. It's amazing. And by the way, I don't get paid for saying that. So, halfway through cooking, we'll season with freshly ground black pepper, then add the pressed garlic and continue cooking until the meat is almost done. Then we'll add some tomato pastry. To get a great kitchen trick for your leftover tomato paste, click on the top right corner of your screen. So we'll stir until well combined and finish cooking the meat. Next, we'll add dry red wine, stir, increase the heat to medium high, and cook until the liquid is evaporated, which includes the fat as well. Not only does the meat absorb it, but we also want the consistency of the sauce to be thick, more concentrated than a bolognese sauce. This might take about 8 to 10 minutes. To this, we'll add fire-roasted crushed tomatoes, granulated sugar, some dried thyme leaves, as well as dried oregano, ground cinnamon, a little bit of ground cloves, and of course, freshly ground black pepper and ground sea salt. We'll give a good stir so the ingredients are well blended before adding a large bay leaf. We'll reduce the heat to medium-low and let it simmer gently for 30 to 35 minutes, stirring occasionally. Now, an ingredient that is not Greek at all that I like to add is cayenne pepper. It gives just a slight kick, a little oomph to the dish. It's optional, but totally recommended. Keep in mind that the bechamel sauce will mellow out all the ingredients, so by adding cayenne, it will bring the dish together nicely. After 30 minutes or so, the sauce should be done. It's okay if there's a little fat at the bottom, as long as it's thick. We'll take the bay leaf out and discard it. We'll remove the saucepan from the heat and let it cool off while we make the bechamel sauce. In a 4-quart pot over medium heat, we'll add butter. And when it's melted, we'll add the equal amount of flour. We'll whisk the roux constantly for 5 minutes to remove the raw taste from the flour. A few minutes later, we should have a nice smooth consistency. So we'll pour in the warm milk while whisking continuously until all incorporated and the sauce is smooth with no lumps. Now, we'll grate some nutmeg. Of course, you can use the one that's already grated, but why? Using fresh is much better. So we'll add about a quarter teaspoon of it, then the same amount of ground sea salt, as well as white pepper. We'll whisk again so the seasonings are well blended. Now we'll introduce the egg yolks to the sauce by scooping up some bechamel and slowly adding it to the yolks, whisking constantly.
We'll continue adding a little at a time until the eggs are tempered. Then, a few ladles later, we'll add the warm yolks to the pot and whisk them into the mixture. Before we continue with the bechamel sauce, we'll start boiling the water in a large pot, adding a fair amount of salt. Now, this is what I use, Bucatini number 2. Most specialty grocers carry it, but if you can't find it, the next best pasta to use is either Ziti or Penny, which will resemble the way a typical pastisio looks. So we'll add the pasta to the boiling salted water and cook for 3 minutes less than the package directions, because it will soften more when we transfer the casserole to the oven. Mine says 12 minutes, therefore I'm setting my timer for 9. While the pasta is cooking, let's go back to the bechamel sauce. We'll add a 1/4 cup at a time of cefalotiri cheese and whisk until well incorporated between each addition. This is an amazing cheese, and it's not as salty as Parmesan. This can also be found in many specialty stores, but don't go out of your way to buy it, because you can substitute with either Parmesan or Romano cheese. After adding all the cheese, the consistency of the sauce should be perfect, not too thick and not too thin. We'll keep it warm while looking after our noodles. When time is up, we'll remove from the heat and drain the pasta into a colander. We'll let them sit for a few minutes to make sure they're well drained before returning them back to the pot. To this, we'll add egg whites and gently stir until well mixed. Then we'll add more cefalotiri cheese, about 1 cup, and combine with the noodles. Adding these ingredients will help the pasta to stick together better when it's time to cut and serve. Now we'll put the pasta mixture in a large, deep baking dish, lightly greased. We'll arrange the noodles lengthwise to get them lined up so we have that nice visual effect when serving. You can use a pasta fork, but I prefer using my clean hands. It's faster that way. Next, we'll top the pasta with the meat sauce and evenly spread it out. As you can see, the sauce is thick, and that's exactly what we want, so it doesn't seep down into the noodles. After pressing it down gently and leveling it out, we'll sprinkle on 1 cup of cheese. I know there's a lot of cheese, which makes this dish so fabulous. Then comes the bechamel sauce, and we'll spread it out evenly as well, smoothing out the surface with a spatula. Guess what? We're adding even more cheese now. I'm so happy. And if you're also a cheese lover, I'm sure you have a big grin on your face too. So we'll use 1.5 cups, enough to cover the entire surface. Okay, it's ready to be baked. But what I like to do is to place my baking dish on a large baking sheet, just in case it overflows. Now we'll transfer to a 350-degree preheated oven and bake for 45 to 50 minutes, or until the top starts getting a little brown. Then we'll put the boiler on low and continue to bake for 5 to 8 minutes, or until it's nice and brown. We'll carefully remove from the heat, sprinkle on some fresh chopped parsley, and let it rest for 15 minutes before serving, so it stays together for a nice presentation. And my friends, this is our pastitio. If you never had this rich casserole before, it has to be on your must-try list this season. It's like having Italian lasagna, but a Greek version, packed with wonderful flavors. After you try this gorgeous baked pasta dish, you'll understand why I love it so much. I hope you give it a try soon, and be sure to visit clubfoodie.com for ingredient amounts, directions, and more. Until next time, my friends, bon appétit.